I rise to move motion number 6 on the order paper 3 that this honorable house adopt the report of the Minister of Western Housing on the contract agreement between Ghana Water Limited, acting on behalf of the Ministry of Plantation, Water Resources, the Government of Ghana, and Fine Water International Limited of England, for an amount of $232,287,980 in respect to the project 100 Tamale Water Supply Scheme. Mr. Speaker, I wish that the Hansa captured the totality of the report of your committee as to be read and specifically submitted as such. I will concentrate on a few of the decisions, recommendations made by your committee. Mr. Speaker, government's agenda of sustainable providing potable water to all Ghanaians has resulted in this project. Due to the increase in population growth and the high demand for adequate potable water supply in primary and in environments, this project will complement other efforts to address the continual water supply challenges in primary and its surrounding communities by providing adequate and reliable drinking water for the year 2040 and beyond. Mr. Speaker, your committee was informed that development and construction phase of the project will be undertaken over a period of 36 months. However, this is subject to changing the information of more details of construction program. Mr. Speaker, the training and technology transfer aspect of the contract is not an idea, since GWCL staff will be trained in water asset management technology by Bywater International. Your committee loves this effort and urges GWCL to ensure that the right staff are recruited for the training. Mr. Speaker, your committee noted that the issue of corporate social responsibility was not explicitly stated in the contract. Hence, your committee was assured that an additional environmental and social impact assessment will be conducted to enable to establish the exact of the affected communities to enable the provision of the right intervention. Mr. Speaker, the Ministry has promised to punish the committee for the copy of the value for money audit report and the loan scheme when it's completed by end of August 2019. Since the value for money audit was in the conception stage at the time of the committee's deliberation. Mr. Speaker, this project, once completed, will provide over 792,000 inhabitants of Tamale and its environs with access to adequate and reliable potable water. This side is the MPP government agenda of ensuring that by the year 2030, all people living in Ghana have access to SDG, SSD program. So we will have access to potable water. The project will also help boost social economic activity in the northern region. Mr. Speaker, your committee, after careful observations and appreciation, the need for increased reliability of the supply by the potable water to the people of the budget area, recommends to this honorable house to adopt the report and approve by resolution the contract agreement in accordance with Article 1815 of the National Constitution of the Republic of Ghana. And finally, Mr. Speaker, your committee wishes to express its profound appreciation to the Honorable Minister, the Chief Deputy, and the Acting Chief Director of the Ministry, the Mighty Director of GWCL, his Chief Deputies, and other officials from the Ministry, and here for their resourceful input and assistance during their complete operation. Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. Welcome.
Yes, the two motions that we have in one. So we have number 5 and then 7. The report is referred to attention. That is, the doctrine of being a separate motion. The same here. So you put the same. So the
four comprehensive motions.
Yeah. setting up the convention on the current property, just the House and Foreign Affairs, on the question of the use of transboundary water to resource international aid service by no Asian Economic Commission for the Road. And also, the dated Convention of Law of Navigation uses of the National Water Course and it's a 1997 Water Course. So, if you present the article, just figure, I wish they had that to capture the entirety of the report of the activity and to do it in the specific situation. I will concentrate on a few of the observations and decisions made by the just figure, these two provisions are important because they ensure the stability and reasonable utilization. The obligation not to cause not harm. The general obligation to incorporate, prevent, reduce, and control pollution. The appropriate exchange of data and information and the protection of conservation of the food system and the aquatic environment. In the figure, over the years, these conventions have been improving their effectiveness as an international legal regime by fostering several international cooperation on water. Therefore, the figure, it would be beneficial to Ghana should be ratified and attend this convention. The figure, the ratification of these two conventions would reinforce Ghana's strategic position of cooperating fully with the US and other global water course countries. It also ensures that effective cooperation and management system are implemented on all transboundary water projects. This figure, effective building is critical for the development of every country. Therefore, by accordingly to the country in every water convention, Ghana may benefit from the use of conventions trust once provided for technical assistance and capacity building for which member countries. Other benefits would include the conventional activities on adaptation to climate change and on transboundary transport management. Mr. Speaker, your committee was informed that ratifying this convention will provide the needed framework for Ghana to enhance the care management of the national water courses and immensely contribute to the implementation of the SDG6. Let's really incorporate on the basis of transboundary norms and standards will be indicated by our adhesion to the Water Convention. This ratification will boost investors' confidence and enhance the good of that British of Ghana in the international. Mr. Speaker, your committee noted that not ratifying water convention would indicate other countries and the international community of Ghana's seeming unwillingness to cooperate on transboundary water issues. There would be also difficulties in the prevention, control, and adoption of significant transboundary activities that affect our transboundary basin. Again, Mr. Speaker, there would be great difficulties in establishing new agreements and bodies for Ghana's transboundary basin if we do not ratify these water conventions. To conclude, Mr. Speaker, Ghana will stand to lose project funding from UNESCO that promotes transboundary water governance, yet joint corporate monitoring of water transition and capacity building, which is if you hesitate to attend these water conventions. Finally, Mr. Speaker, your committee, after careful examination of the various articles and clauses and the numerous benefits of the two water convention, commend to this honorable house to approve the ratification of the convention on the protection and the use of transboundary water course and tertiary lake service by the United Nations Economic Commission, we recognize the two water convention. The United Nations Convention on the Law of the Non-Navigational Use of International Water Course, National Water Course, Conservative, especially so in general. 149,498 for the 2020 financial year. So I will submit a report for the committee. Mr. Speaker, I wish the answer to capture the whole report as reported by Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, in the year 2019, the ministry was allocated with a budgetary amount of 2,802,892. Mr. Speaker, out of this amount, 80% was allocated to infrastructure management and 20% was built to human settlement development and management and administration. Mr. Speaker, to consolidate the gains made by the ministry in the previous year, 2019, the ministry has allocated amounts of 147,529,298 for the 2020 year. Mr. Speaker, 35% of this amount has been allocated to address the infrastructure management challenges of the country. 90% has been built to solve the human deficit, and 10% for the management of the effective administration of the ministry. Mr. Speaker, again, Mr. Speaker, the committee was informed of the indefinite of the ministry to the contractor, which has a potential risk of being dragged to the law court. This huge indefinite is mainly due to delays and non-release of budgetary allocation to the ministry. The committee, Mr. Speaker, is appealing to this ordinance, saying the ministry allocates indefinite. Mr. Speaker, your committee expressed concern about the current high cost of the affordable housing project, which defeated the intention of the project. Your committee, Mr. Speaker, was satisfied about the continuous delay in the completion of the affordable housing project, since this also contributed to the high cost of the project. The ministry assured the committee of their preparedness and commitment to continue with the remaining works. Mr. Speaker, your committee has reflected up issued the 2,208 to the ministry, which the comment in the House of to the sum of 147,529,298 enable the ministry for West House to implement this disposal program in activity as it strives to achieve its mission safety. Mr. Speaker, your committee is thankful to the Honorable Minister and two deputies for the technical team, as well as the officers from the Ministry of Finance for their explanation and assistance to the deliberation of the committee. In conclusion, Mr. Speaker, your committee wish to re-echo this appeal to the Ministry of Finance to enable the Ministry of Western Housing to set its outstanding financial commitment in the contract. Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, I rise to second the motion for the approval of the annual estimate budget for the Ministry of Sanitation and Water Resources of an amount of 360,168.622 for 2020 financial year, and so doing, I present the committee report. Mr. Speaker, in presenting the committee's report, I will comment on a few of the observations and recommendations and direct the answer to capture the whole report as we read by executive. Mr. Speaker, the Ministry of Sanitation and Water Resources has over the years worked to fulfill its goals and objectives of contributing to improve the living standards of Ghanaians through increased access to the use of safe water, improved sanitation and hygiene practices, and sustainable management of water resources nationwide. Mr. Speaker, to fulfill this mandate, the Ministry in 2019 recorded significant success, including the deployment of about 4,000 litter bins across selected MDAs in six regions, the procurement of 24 normal boiler taxis, the re-engineering of landfill facilities into sustainable state-of-the-art waste treatment facilities, the Upper East Region, the Regional West Water Supply Project, the Greater Accra Metropolitan Town Area Sanitation Water Project,
the enhancement of the sustainable rural water and sanitation project to serve more households and progressively providing adequate solid and liquid waste management among others. Mr. Speaker, the Ministry informed your committee on the gains made in area of sanitation, such as the construction of about 22,500 household toilets, the installation of about 20,000 signal load toilets, the construction of 35 special toilets, the construction of 144 special toilets, and the regular. Due to this project, among other interventions, 422 out of 500 communities have been declared COVID infection free. Despite the milestone achieved in the area of sanitation, Mr. Speaker, your committee urged the ministry to identify its lead role in promoting and improving the sanitation coverage nationwide. Mr. Speaker, your committee observed that one major challenge to the ministry was the untimely release of budgetary allocation. As of September 2019, only 50% of the budgeted amount for 2019 has been released. Mr. Speaker, the committee wished to urge the Ministry of Finance to ensure full timely release of budgetary allocation to the ministry to enable it to effectively work towards the achievement of SDG Goal 6 of ensuring availability and sustainable management of water and sanitation for all. Mr. Speaker, your committee still reiterates this firm belief that for effective leadership, harmonization, coordination, policy and strategy formulation, sanitation and implementation of all of the programs and projects must be brought under the direct leadership of the Ministry of Education and Development Resources. This will ensure effective efficiency, harmonization, and immediate implementation of the efforts of the community. Mr. Speaker, to win in the fight against poor sanitation in the country, the committee urged the ministry to call for stronger inter-ministerial and strengthened collaboration of all stakeholders in water, sanitation, and health sector. The MCs, the media, the society, and the citizenry must all be involved in addressing the sanitation challenges. Mr. Speaker, the committee, after the presentation of the budget, wishes to commend this honorable house